midst of an infrastructure crisis. Millions of roads, bridges, water systems, and other assets have outlived their useful life and need to be replaced. The Sellwood Bridge here in Portland, Oregon, it provides one example of how Autodesk technology is helping solve the infrastructure crisis.
The Sellwood Bridge was built in the 1920s, and the people who designed it didn't know about the landslide that they were building the bridge on. So over the decades, the hillside kept moving and the bridge didn't, and we had a lot of crunching happening there. And eventually, you know, 80 years after the bridge was open to the public, it had some real severe cracks on it. We had to lower the weight limit for vehicles crossing the bridge down to just 10 tons, which is very low. And we eventually, when that happened, we knew we had to do something.
In 2005, they went around and rated all the structural integrity of the bridges in the United States, and they rated it a 2 out of 100, which means it's about to fall over. It's not doing very well at all.
Well, the contractor in the Sellwood Bridge project came up with a very innovative idea that no one at the county had thought about, and that was, how can we shorten the construction time, save money, and still keep the bridge open? And they came up with this very bold idea to actually move the steel truss that is carries most of the Sellwood Bridge, to actually move it out of the way and then demolish the remaining supports in the river. And this would give them the space to build the new bridge in one phase instead of two phases, which was the old way we thought it would have to be done. And this was a very innovative idea, the idea of moving something that's like 1,500 feet long and pushing it north to put it on a new alignment. It was a very innovative, very bold idea. And because of that, there was skepticism about it. You know, I don't think anything that long had ever been moved in that particular way before. And having a good visual explanation of how that would happen was very key in, I could say, selling the idea to our leaders who had to feel comfortable with it, and then the neighbors who lived around it, who were affected by it. And having the visuals, and we actually had an animated piece that would show the different phases, and just you could watch it in just a minute to understand it. It was really helpful.
The Sellwood Bridge is a project that is ripe with complexity. We have the landslide on the west bank, we have extreme congestion on the east bank, and an existing infrastructure that needs to be replaced, but also operational the entire time. And as a result, the design as well as the construction is very complex. There's a lot of sequencing involved. And the use of technology and 3D visualization allows these complexities to be explained in a visual format that people are used to seeing. You're used to going to the movies and seeing a Pixar movie or a 3D animation that it tells a story. And we can use that same medium to tell a very complex construction story to the residents that are going to be using this every day.
When you can see something in three dimension, when it can be put in front of you and it's three-dimensional, you can really understand it. Two-dimensional drawings many times are just flat drawings. A lot of people don't understand what they're looking at and they get lost in the process. Three-dimension really shows you exactly what's going to happen, where things are going to fit, how it's going to go.
The technology that we have been recently given within the past 4 or 5 years has changed how we approach pre-construction. Now, instead of coming up with an idea and thinking that it'll work and waiting until you're out in the field to find out that it doesn't work, or paying an engineering firm to go in and specifically create an entire structure that they know would be constructible, we can now get into these environments and in real time take things almost like Play-Doh and put them in place and remove them and switch parts. And so it gives somebody like me or like another project engineer the ability to get in and kind of explore thoughts in almost a fluid manner. Something that would have taken textbooks to go through and figure out what the size of a W24 by 55 beam is, we can now start to look at this in an environment by the click of a button. As sites transition to more of a digital job site, it's going to remove many of the obstacles that aging infrastructure faces. On a vertical project, whether it's a new office building or a new school, you can put a fence around the site and say, we are using this area for the next 3 years. But on a piece of infrastructure, you cannot do that. That is not an option. As a result of that, there's so many minor complexities that are forced into the job site zone that need to be dealt with on a daily basis. And with a digital job site, the interaction between the public and the construction team and the design team and the engineering team can be so much more fluid. There's so much less miscommunication that happens, that the product that ends up in the field is not only more of the original design intent, but it also, the construction sequencing to get to it is much more efficient and adequately addresses needs and issues that might arise during the construction process.
Oregon's Sellwood Bridge is just one of the many projects around the world where Autodesk technology is helping civil engineers, builders, and infrastructure owners solve their most complex design and engineering challenges. There are millions of roads, highways, bridges, water, and other critical assets in need of renovation and replacement throughout the world. And with the growing use of cloud and mobile technology, Autodesk is working to empower the civil infrastructure industry to tackle these projects in a whole new way. For more information, visit www.autodesk.com/infrastructure.